What Voyager 1 and 2 detected beyond our solar system? NASA launched the Voyager 1 and Voyager 2 spacecraft from Earth in 1977. Their mission was to explore Jupiter, Saturn, and the farthest planets in the solar system. This was a remarkable feat because no object made in the past by human beings had tried a journey as risky and distant as this. Both ships were initially scheduled to operate for 4 or 5 years, but surprisingly, exceeding all expectations, the ships are still operating after 44 years. Thanks to this, the probes have discovered incredible findings at the edge of the solar system. Get ready to discover it. The Voyager 1 and 2 probes are the objects created by the human race that has gone the furthest. Currently, Voyager 1 is 22,000 million kilometers from Earth, while Voyager 2 is 18,000 million kilometers from Earth. Thanks to all the time they have traveled, today both spacecraft have exceeded the limits of the solar system and are currently sailing in the interstellar medium. During their journey through the solar system, the two spacecraft took dozens of images of Jupiter and Saturn. The images from Voyager 1 and 2 allowed us to see many things for the first time. For example, they capture photos of Jupiter's clouds and storms and the structure of Saturn's rings. Voyager 1 and 2 also discovered active volcanoes on Io, one of Jupiter's moons. Voyager 2 also took the first images of Uranus and Neptune, and together, both spacecraft managed to discover 22 moons. Since then, these ships have continued their journey away from us. Both continue to send information back to Earth. This data will help us understand distant solar and interstellar space conditions. Voyagers have enough fuel and power to operate through 2025. After some time, they will no longer be able to communicate with the Earth and will be completely turned off for the rest of eternity. Unless something or someone stops them, the Voyager spacecraft will continue to pass through new stars repeatedly for thousands of years, carrying the message of humanity with them. Each Voyager spacecraft carries a gold disc with scenes and sounds from Earth. The discs also contain music and greetings in different languages. So if intelligent life ever encounters these spacecraft, they will be able to know about Earth and us. The limits of the solar system. Thanks to the Voyager probes, we have discovered the layers surrounding the solar system. Years ago, it was unknown what the limit was of the solar system. But now we know that in reality, the solar system is surrounded by several layers. These are 1. Heliosphere, the region where all the planets of the solar system and all layers surrounding the sun are located. 2. Termination shock front, an area beyond Pluto where the solar wind's influence is almost no longer felt. 3. Heliosheath, the zone between the termination shock front and the heliopause at the solar system's outer edge. It extends along the edge of the heliosphere. 4. Heliopause, the point at which the solar wind binds to the interstellar medium or stellar wind coming from other stars. 5. Bow shock, region where solar radiation stops being felt entirely and begins to dominate interstellar radiation. 6. Oort cloud, it is a spherical cloud asteroids with billions of microasteroids and planetesimals surrounding the entire solar system. Currently, the Voyager probes have crossed all the layers of the solar system except for 2, the bow shock and the Oort cloud. It is estimated that with the speed they carry, they will reach the Oort cloud in about 300 or 400 years, and it will take approximately 30,000 to 40,000 years to traverse that region completely. Unexpected discoveries. When Voyagers traversed the heliosheath of the solar system, they detected a strange anomaly. Maybe you didn't know this, but the sun's magnetic field is very different from the magnetic field of the planets. This is because matter behaves differently in the sun's core, which influences the behavior of the magnetic field, which rotates in opposite directions at the north and the south poles, contrary to what happens on Earth, where the magnetic field is more homogeneous at the poles. This rotation of the sun's magnetic field produces a magnetic wave, that spreads throughout the solar system called the heliospheric current, which has a shape very similar to the waves that occur when you drop a stone into water. The strange thing is that this wave is not homogeneous throughout the solar system, but when it reaches the limits of the termination shock front, the waves are compressed as if they were hitting an invisible wall. The Voyager probes detected this anomaly since the signals they sent showed magnetic bubbles formed in that region, and only in that region. This means that the boundary of the solar system's heliosheath is not a quiet region as astronomers believed, but it is a turbulent zone with fluctuating magnetic changes interacting with the electronic systems of devices and spacecraft. Thanks to this discovery, we have had to redo the heliosheath model and the rest of the solar system to fit with the new findings. In 2012, Voyager 1 officially left the heliosphere, becoming the first object created by humanity to leave the solar system. However, this announcement generated more doubt than exaltation in the scientific community, because Voyager crossed the heliopause when it was 120 astronomical units from the Sun. Remember that an astronomical unit is an average distance between the Sun and the Earth, about 150 million kilometers. This was quite a finding, since until then, astronomers did not know how far away the limit of the heliosphere was. We knew there was a limit, but we didn't know where it ended. The Voyagers helped us solve that great mystery. Later, on November 5, 2018, Voyager 2 would also leave the limits of the heliosphere, becoming the only two objects created by humanity to leave the solar system. Like Voyager 1, Voyager 2 also left the solar system when it was 120 astronomical units from the Sun, which was something strange. Why? Every 11 years, solar activity increases and decreases in constant and predictable cycles. The scientists' theoretical models predicted that these solar cycles increased or decreased the solar wind, so the size of the heliosphere should fluctuate on those dates. However, both Voyagers left the heliosphere at the same distance, 6 years apart, which means that during those 6 years, the heliosphere had no changes, so it probably does not fluctuate as the theoretical models pointed out and is much more stable than we thought. If you're liking this video, let us know by leaving a like, subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, and don't forget to ring the notification bell so you don't miss any of our videos. Voyager 1 is starting to fail. Despite its age, everything indicates that Voyager 1 is still working correctly. However, NASA engineers working on this spacecraft have recently been baffled by the probe's articulation and control system. It is generating data that appears to be completely random. Specifically, scientists discovered that the spacecraft successfully receives and executes orders from Earth, but the readings from the probe's Attitude Control and Articulation Systems, AACS, which keeps the spacecraft and its antenna in the proper orientation, do not reflect what happens aboard Voyager 1. The AACS is sending the spacecraft's manipulators junk telemetry data. Engineers aren't sure if the problem is coming directly from that system or another part of the ship. In addition, the twin probe, Voyager 2, also launched in 1977, usually behaves according to NASA. According to several scientific media, there is a possibility that NASA will not find the source of the problem and will have to introduce changes to the software or use one of the ship's backup systems, something that was already done in 2017. Voyagers are shutting down. The team in charge of the Voyager spacecraft continues to examine the data they send us from the far reaches of the solar system. However, it is a relatively slow process since a signal from Earth currently takes 20 hours and 33 minutes to reach Voyager 1, while to receive the spacecraft's response carries the same delay. Each probe has a long-lasting radioisotope thermoelectric generator that converts heat from the decaying plutonium isotope 238 into electrical energy. However, this energy is not eternal. Sooner or later, it will run out, which is why NASA is starting to shut down some spacecraft systems to save the maximum amount of energy. Even engineers have already said that, in the best-case scenario, the ships will completely deplete their power supply by 2025, and once that happens, they will shut down forever. Once the Voyager shut down, they will remain in complete darkness, wandering through interstellar space, eternally adrift. Several thousand years will likely pass near some stars, and it is estimated that in 40,000 years, Voyager 1 will leave the solar system towards the star AC+793888, located in the constellation Camillopardalis. Voyager 2 will pass within 4.3 light-years of the star Sirius in about 296,000 years. Will any extraterrestrial civilization ever encounter these ships in the history of the universe? That is a question that we still have no answer to. Likely, that will never happen, or that, if it does, it may be millions of years after humanity has disappeared from the face of the Earth. It is possible that the Voyager ships lasted even longer than human civilization. Or who knows, it may be that in the future, we will develop such advanced technology that allows us to travel in a few days the distance that the Voyager probes took several decades. What do you think? What do you think will happen to the Voyager probes in the future? Let us know your opinion with your valuable comment.